Warning, sodium hydroxide and sulfuric acid are both highly corrosive. Be sure to wear proper protective equipment. A fine mist of sodium hydroxide is inevitably created during this process, so be sure to work outside or in a fume hood. Today, I thought it would be kind of fun to turn one of my old glass test tubes into a puddle of slime. And no, I don't mean by melting it, although that is somewhat of a necessary step. To do this, we'll only need three ingredients: sodium hydroxide, an acid, and some form of glass. I'm going to be using sulfuric acid and this old test tube, and the sodium hydroxide just came from the store as this crystal drain cleaner. We'll also need a steel or iron reaction vessel of some kind and a strong heat source. I opted for my blowtorch. To start, we'll add an arbitrary amount of sodium hydroxide to the steel vessel. This is then heated with the torch until it melts. You can melt sodium hydroxide on a stovetop, but a torch is obviously much faster. Once the sodium hydroxide is molten, submerge the glass you wish to dissolve into it. The sodium hydroxide will now slowly begin to act on the glass, turning it into water vapor and a chemical known as sodium silicate. Sodium silicate doesn't really have a definite formula, and its properties vary depending on how much glass is dissolved into it. If the mixture contains higher levels of glass, it will dissolve more poorly in water, have a lower pH, and will melt at a higher temperature. Since I want all my glass to melt and dissolve in water later, I'll be using more sodium hydroxide than silicon dioxide. You can see here the effects of sodium hydroxide on the melting point of glass. By heating the glass while it's covered in sodium hydroxide, it's actually possible to melt it with my torch into a runny liquid. Now, since the reaction to produce sodium silicate proceeds faster at higher temperatures, I use this effect on glass to my advantage to help things dissolve faster. After a while, the glass will be fully dissolved into the sodium hydroxide. At this point, allow the mixture to cool and then submerge the vessel in the water to dissolve out the sodium silicate. Don't add the molten mixture to water, as it will burst explosively and could damage your glassware. Once the sodium silicate is dissolved, filter the solution a few times to remove any unreacted glass or contaminants. In the end, we are left with a clear solution of sodium silicate in water. And now for the fun part, recreating the glass, but as a slime. To do this, I'll be using sulfuric acid, but any acid will do. As the acid is added to the sodium silicate, some carbon dioxide might bubble out, since some of the sodium hydroxide tends to absorb carbon dioxide, forming sodium carbonate. Once all the acid is added, a white, gelatinous precipitate will form. This is actually glass, or more specifically, a hydrated form of glass known as silica gel. Some of the silica is also still dissolved in solution as the compound known as silicic acid, which is actually pretty cool when you consider how insoluble sand and other forms of silicon dioxide are. And there you have it, turning rock-hard glass into a puddle of silica gel slime. Hopefully you learned something new in this video. If so, be sure to like, share, and subscribe, since there are a lot more videos on the way. And if you want to help support my work, consider donating or becoming my patron on Patreon. Links are in the video description. Until next time, LabCoatz out.